Morning, everyone. I'm about to drive to Claudia. We're gonna do some filming today, maybe cook something, do a little vlog perhaps. The weather is really nice. It's sunny. Well, now it's kind of cloudy, but it was sunny a minute ago. And yeah, by the way, I got the new puffer from Zara, the one I actually talked about. It's really nice. It's like a crop. It's quite cute and it's got that like leather finish, so it's nice when it's raining. But it's super hot. Like, this is for winter. Like, I'm dying. Anyway, it's gonna take me 1 hour to drive to her, so I better go. I had to stop to get her food. Not her food, the kitten food, because I live next to the pet shop. And yeah. So I just got to Claudia.
Yeah, we're gonna go. I think we're gonna go to shop and get something for lunch.
We might get food for lunch and also for dinner.
Yeah, I think we're gonna cook something because we've been ordering food every single day and I'm kind of sick of it.
Yeah.
I feel like we need something homemade.
We haven't cooked in so long.
Yeah, so long. I kind of miss, you know, healthy meals.
Yeah, homemade meals. Yeah. Although I don't know if I can cook right now for lunch. Maybe for dinner.
No, I think for lunch we're gonna get something, you know,
ready-made. Because I'm too hungry for that.
Yeah, should we go?
Yeah. So this is the jacket from Zara. I really like it.
It's quite soft actually.
It's very soft and like short.
They had a black one as well, right?
Yeah. Right. What do we have in here?
We've got some soup.
We're gonna have a soup for lunch and then we're gonna make some chicken.
Yeah.
With mozzarella. What else do we need? We need potatoes.
No, we need cherry sun-dried tomatoes.
So this shop is super small, but we found all we needed. So yeah. Okay, so we got these tomato soups from Waitrose.
Tomato basil passion flower.
These are really nice. I've had them before.
Yeah, I've had these before. They're really kind of like healthy.
They taste like you're in a restaurant.
Yeah. What we're gonna do is we're actually gonna add some cream to it.
Yeah,
you know?
I've added cream last time and it was so creamy and yummy.
Like to make like a tomato creamy soup. Yeah. And also some basil because
some basil.
Basil.
I don't know.
Basil. Maybe basil. And then we got these olive bread. It's like a kind of olive roll and it's super nice.
We're gonna put it
in the microwave. Oh yeah, mixed olive roll. We're gonna put it in the microwave to kind of heat it up and have it with some bread. Ooh. That's gonna be our lunch for today.
Yeah, so this is the lunch.
Quick and easy.
Very easy and quick.
And yummy. So we like to heat the soup on a stove.
Not in the microwave, it's much better.
I do it sometimes in the microwave.
I like to do it in a pot.
I don't have time for that and then I don't want to wash this. So this is a vegan, gluten-free, dairy-free, low-fat, high-fiber, no artificial preservatives, no added sugar as well. So.
How many calories?
So this got... Wait, I don't know. How many... it's a 500-gram soup.
Yeah.
160 calories.
Yeah.
What? That's so little.
That's really little. Well, we need bread and butter.
Yeah.
And cheese, maybe. You know, I actually put cheese on top of this once.
Ew.
Parmesan.
Not cheese with tomato soup. Why? And we're gonna heat them separately because I don't want to mix. Like, I want to have my amount.
Oh, come on.
Like, my 500 gram amount.
Okay. Put the cream, no?
Not yet, at the end.
Okay. This needs to...
Are you gonna put any different spices to make it a bit
Fancy? Some salt.
I think I'm gonna put salt, pepper, and maybe some chili flakes.
Right, let's add some salt. We like some salt, some chili flakes to make it like spicy.
And make it a bit more flavorsome. Although it's really flavorsome already. It's quite like yummy.
This is definitely one of those nice soups.
Mm. I think you need to heat this up for like at least 3-4 minutes.
Alright,
and then at the end we're gonna add some cream.
Right, this is pretty much ready. I'm gonna add some cream to it.
How much cream are you gonna add?
Just like a little bit. This is double cream because, you know, I like it double.
Ooh,
double.
It's quite thick.
Last time I added like...
Not too much.
That much. It's gonna be nice and creamy.
Mmm.
There you go. A good amount. You need a good amount.
Maybe even more. I mean, maybe that's enough.
No, look. I think I've added enough. Because it looks pretty.
But doesn't it need to be like more creamy looking?
No, this is
fine. You don't want it to taste like cream.
I do. I mean, maybe not.
Trust me, I've added a lot.
Okay.
Alright, so that's it.
Alright, that's ready. Lunch, quick and ready.
Oh, put it in basil! The bowl. Yeah, let's put this in a bowl.
Okay.
Right, we're gonna pour the soup.
I think tomato soup is my favorite.
Yeah, my favorite too.
I do like chickens. Chicken noodles.
Oh yeah, chicken noodles.
And some basil.
Shall I put like whole?
Maybe that's too big. I mean, I don't know, however you like it.
I like to like maybe do this.
Nice.
So yeah, it's our favorite type of lunch.
This is looking good.
I like soups when it's cold outside, you know?
Yeah, for winter.
Right, I'm gonna try this soup because I've never tried it with a cream, so let's hope it's good. It's so good.
Mmm, how good is that soup?
So good, but maybe even more cream would be good.
Mm-hmm.
No, I feel like it's literally a soup like you would get in a restaurant. That's how good it tastes.
Mmm, yeah.
Usually I really hate soups that come like ready.
Same.
But this soup is really nice.
Mmm.
It's really nice and salty. Let's have some of this bread. We put it in the microwave. This is my favorite bread at the moment. Oh my gosh, it's so soft. I've been literally eating this bread like every day.
Every other day.
It's got olives inside, right?
And we have some salt butter.
Salt butter. Yeah, with like a lot of butter.
Yeah, like really a lot.
Oh yeah.
Mmm,
go. This butter is so salty. Oh my god.
How salty is this
butter?
Oh
my god. It's almost too salty and I like my salt.
Mmm.
Good. So UK is going into lockdown on Thursday.
Yeah.
We literally have 3 days to do...
Today's Monday.
Yeah, today's Monday, we have like 3 days to do any last minute, I don't know what, outings.
Last minute lunches.
Basically everything's gonna be closed again. Like shops, restaurants. You're not supposed to even leave the house, you know? Like before, basically.
Well, I need to leave the house to come to you.
We work together, so that's fine.
You can leave the house for work, but not really like for no reason.
I might be going to Dubai next week.
Really?
Yeah, I might escape this madness.
But we need to film some videos before.
We're gonna film a lot of videos before, so hopefully we're gonna have enough footage.
So yeah, today we're basically just gonna film like a casual day with us.
The day with us. We haven't done much today and it's kind of late already, but I need to edit
this
video.
This is pretty much how our day is. We just eat.
I feel like we need to have a proper plan for this lockdown. I mean, if you're going to Dubai, then maybe not you, but for me, I feel like I wanna go on a kind of a detox, maybe.
Yeah.
During these 4 weeks, or maybe it's gonna be more even, I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're saying it might be like till next year.
What?
Yeah.
Oh,
I hope not.
No, I don't want that.
I don't know about you, but I'm getting full.
Me too, and we haven't even finished, like, this soup is big. Yeah, usually I don't have bread with it, but I don't know what happened today. I kind of just wanted bread and a lot of butter. Oh my gosh, so yesterday I watched this movie. It was called, like an old movie. What was it called? Legends of the Fall with Brad Pitt, and it was really good. I can't believe I never watched this movie because it's like, you know, one of the classics that I think won Oscars or something.
I think I've watched it, I don't know.
It was good. And he was super hot in that movie.
Yeah.
Was it like in old days?
Mm-hmm.
Like Texas something.
Yeah, like on the ranch. Like,
yeah.
Horses type.
By the way, I think I'm finally gonna do my house tour, right?
We are finally gonna film the house tour.
Probably this week.
Probably, yeah.
Yeah.
If I clean the house.
I need to clean the house.
Well,
first.
You need to clean the house and we're gonna film it this week, so.
That will be up soon.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, Laura, we need to stop with this butter. We ate half of it already.
Oh.
Like,
you did?
I mean, yeah, maybe I'm going quite heavy with it. I can't stop eating these days. Like, I don't know what's happened to me.
Maybe like, you're pregnant.
Literally everyone is pregnant. I'm not pregnant, okay?
Yeah.
I'm not pregnant,
sorry.
But everyone is
fashion for babies.
Pregnant. Emrata is pregnant. All the Victoria's Secret models.
Cardi Bible is pregnant. That took me by surprise, but yeah. I kind of knew it.
Yeah, same.
Mm. I kind of knew she's pregnant.
This is kind of like a mukbang. Us eating a
mukbang, but there's no questions.
Oh, maybe we should do a mukbang again. With questions, probably.
Oh, KFC mukbang. That's like my favorite.
Yesterday I had KFC. And they literally gave us the wrong order. There was nothing. We got two burgers, the burgers didn't come, the gravy didn't come for my mashed potato. Literally nothing. I was so angry.
No, but this is a good idea. We can do a mukbang. Or we can do like a Chinese food. With like noodles.
Chinese, yeah.
That would be good.
Mm-hmm. I found a good Chinese.
Yeah?
Mm. How about we do it now? We ask the questions on our stories, on Instagram stories, and we have some questions for later to answer.
Oh yeah, we could do that. We could answer them with our dinner.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Like a spontaneous Q&A maybe?
Yeah, let's do it. Because we don't have anything else to do today. This video is going to be boring.
True.
Yeah, could do that.
Right, we're going to finish the soup and then we'll catch with you later.
Yeah, she's so sleepy.
Aww, she came so here cute.
To sleep, didn't you?
She's growing already quite fast.
Yeah, look how big she is. I mean, she's still little, but before she was like as small as my hand.
Yeah,
oh, she's big. Aww. She likes to eat my nails.
She likes to eat everything. Yeah. Hide your shoes because Biggie destroyed my shoes this morning.
Well, she's destroying everything so far, but
yeah, but Biggie, my cat, started scratching all like my both of my boots, and he actually bit it that the leather is coming off. So I got so upset about that.
Ow! You know she actually bites quite hard.
Does she?
Yeah.
Look how pretty she is. She's got like kind of green gray eyes.
Yeah, kind of like the same color as her.
I can't really see it, but I'm gonna do some work now on my laptop.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm gonna edit a video.
So I think I'm gonna edit some pictures. I'm a bit too full now to even move or do anything.
Same.
She's gonna sleep here now.
Yeah, she's like a little baby.
Aww, baby. Oh. All right. You like my nails? I think she's licking the butter from my fingers.
Yeah. Right, I'm gonna edit my Santorini vlog that I kind of forgot about.
Yeah, you did.
I forgot about this vlog, but yeah.
She likes to play with hair as well. Look.
You should be careful because she's gonna scratch your face.
No.
Okay, so we decided we're gonna do the questions now.
Yes, because later it's a bit difficult to kind of eat and answer questions. At least I find it difficult.
Same. Unless it's a proper mukbang, we yeah. decided we're gonna do it now because we got actually a lot of questions.
Yes, we got quite a few questions, so we're just gonna do it now.
Yeah, we're gonna go through them. We're having some cider, you know. We haven't answered questions in a long time, so...
This is a funny question. What do you do about frenemies?
We don't have frenemies. Well, first of all, we don't have that many friends, so we don't have enemies.
But if we do have a friend that's kind of like our enemy, we don't speak with them, so...
Yeah, so we don't really...
We are the type of people that we're not gonna speak. Like, yeah.
To be honest, we're quite bad of a friends.
Yeah.
Like, we have each other, so we don't really... We're not the type of person who's gonna message you first.
Yeah.
We're gonna wait for the...
I mean, sometimes we do.
I guess, yeah. With our friends.
But we don't really have frenemies. That's a new word. I've never heard this before.
Mm.
Yeah. Oh, do you still like the terracotta bronzer? I want to try. I actually really like it and I really want to buy it again because it was really dark,
that bronzer.
So the terracotta bronzer, it's got a very reddish,
reddish
undertone. So for us, because when we sunbathe, we get like reddish here. Yeah. So it's perfect for like holiday or when sunbathing.
Or like during summer, we use this bronzer and it's nice, like a shade.
Because now we're kind of using fake tan, we're more of like a yellow undertone.
Yeah, like olive yellow.
Yeah, so this bronzer is more of a red. Unless
there is probably a few different shades.
Yeah, I'm sure there's different shades, but it's mostly like reddish.
Yeah, true.
So I like it. Oh, somebody asked, how do you keep yourself so well groomed all the time? Tips, please.
Well, we don't really look groomed all the time.
Yeah!
No, nobody looks like this all the time, trust
me. Yeah, don't believe what you say on the internet.
If you see me yesterday, how I looked yesterday, so yesterday was Sunday, after the Halloween, oh my gosh, I looked like a homeless person. Hair all over the place, face white, sweatshirts, like I literally look same, I look even worse, like my nails needs doing.
The clothes that I wear at home, it's like literally like the worst clothes ever. Like nothing matches together. Pink socks,
ew,
green jumper,
Nobody looks like good all the time, but you know, sometimes we definitely always make sure we have our nails done and usually.
But sometimes we don't even wash our hair for like a week.
Yeah.
Depends what we're doing.
Yeah, if we're not doing anything interesting, there's no point. We just
we're not gonna wash
ponytail,
the hair.
You know, we slick it back.
We're not gonna do makeup. I'm not even gonna put moisturizer in the morning. Like, I swear.
Gonna even wash my face in the morning.
There you go, that's how groomed we are.
In the evening I will, but sometimes. If I have hangover, whatever.
Which twin edits the YouTube videos?
Both of us.
We both do it. Like, who's gonna edit this video? You.
Yeah. We basically take turns.
Yeah, we take turns. So like, one day I edit one and one day she edits one. So.
Laura edited the vlogs, like the long vlogs, because she's like a, you know, perfectionist, so she wants to do it.
Feel like you don't know how to do
it. What do you mean I don't know how?
Like, I need to teach you. But let me tell you, these vlogs to edit was a nightmare.
Yeah, it takes at least a week to edit.
Like, well, maybe not a week, like the other one took me 4 days, but it was 4 hours of footage. And because we're Libras, we're very indecisive.
Oh, we're so indecisive. There is a clip that's like three the same clips. We're gonna literally sit for 1 hour thinking which one to choose.
Like, we have a bad, like, we literally cannot choose. Mm. So that's why it also takes pretty long, but yeah.
Yeah, we take turns.
We take turns.
Usually I edit the makeup videos, right?
Yeah.
And you edit like vlogs.
Yeah. Sometimes I edit vlogs as well.
How long have you been with your boyfriend?
Well, kind of like last month was 4 years, so.
I'm gonna be 4 years in April, so now like 3.5, I guess. If you weren't doing YouTube, what would you do for work?
I don't know.
I mean, we weren't doing YouTube 2 years ago, we were just taking pictures for Instagram.
Yeah, just like an influencer, right?
Like an Instagram influencer. Mm. But maybe I would be... I definitely wouldn't want to work for someone.
No.
Because I don't like that. I don't like when people tell me what to do.
Because you like to tell people what to do.
Seriously.
Well, I'm a natural boss.
Whatever.
How many times per week do you work out and what kind of workouts do you do?
Well, the last time I worked out was 2 weeks ago. So yeah.
Yeah, I didn't do a workout for also about a week maybe. But since we came back from Crete, so it's been like maybe 2 months since we came back from Crete or something?
I maybe did my workout like 7 times. 8 at max.
I did once.
What?
Since our birthday, I did workout once. And I couldn't even do it. It was like a half an hour workout. We do workouts from YouTube. Yeah, usually from YouTube. We do Heather Robertson.
Yeah.
Or Penny. What's her name? Penny.
If you put Penny workouts, you'll see it.
Yeah, Penny something from Australia.
So yeah.
These are like our favorite. We do like a hit with weights. Usually no repeat.
Yeah,
that's what we do. We didn't go to gym for a really long time.
I brought some dessert.
We have a little profiteroles.
I don't really like profiteroles.
You know what's funny? My boyfriend came home the other day. He brought 3 packs of those and 2 packs of eclairs. And I'm like, who is gonna eat that? Like,
are you
absolutely ridiculous?
I like the ones that have ice cream inside and don't look wet. Because I don't like eclairs because they're usually wet.
Are these wet? I'm scared.
They're not wet. I opened them today.
They're just a bit sweaty.
I don't like sweaty things.
So good though.
I mean, nice chocolate.
Mmm. My favorite.
Mmm.
There you go, this is our mukbang.
Mm-hmm.
Do you struggling with maybe depression or anxiety?
Oh yeah, we've had depression throughout the whole year.
You know, with the lockdown.
I'm not really struggling with depression, but anxiety, we have a big anxiety.
Oh, we have a big anxiety.
And we said this many times on our YouTube.
We have social anxiety.
We have social anxiety, especially now with age. I think
The older it's we get, the worse it gets, right?
Yeah, it gets worse. We get super bad anxiety when we take pictures in public.
Yeah.
We get like stressy. We're like, oh my gosh, we can't pose. Like last time, I don't know, we were meeting in like a shopping mall, like whatever, and I was waiting. We met in Selfridges, and Laura was calling me because she said, "Where are you? You're not here, and I'm alone, and I have anxiety.
I literally cannot be anywhere on my own."
Yeah,
can you be?
No, because I feel like people looking, and they just kind of like,
and they want to talk to you. Like, I don't like strangers talking to me.
Like, we're very awkward, but yeah, we do have anxiety. But I guess we just need to like overcome it.
When we're together, we're better.
We overcome it when we're drunk.
True.
There's no anxiety when we have a bit of a percentage, but yeah, like for example, if we're together in town and someone wants to talk to us, I'm fine. But if I'm alone, I literally want to hide in the bathroom, like in the toilet somewhere. I swear.
Well, yeah, I think a lot of people suffer from it.
Well, depression, maybe not like actual depression that like doctor says, yeah, you have depression. Like,
no, we don't have depression, no.
But maybe like a bit of a... like a little depression, you know, like, oh, what's going on with this, you know, corona time.
Corona time.
It's a bit sad times.
Yeah. You know,
for everyone. We're gonna be strong. By the way, I wanna watch the Secret movie.
Oh, yeah.
The one on Netflix. What's the name of it?
It's not on Netflix. It's on Prime and also on Apple.
Oh, right. This, I don't know what this is.
It's something that...
The Secret to Life?
No, I don't know.
Something is this, the Secret made the movie basically, so we want to watch it because, you know, it's gonna give us positive vibes,
motivation
to be happy, whatever.
Food that you don't eat.
I think we eat everything.
Yeah, we eat everything.
Yeah.
Well, there is few things I'm not fan of.
I'm not fussy at all, I can eat anything.
Will you eat blue cheese?
No.
Exactly.
Okay, blue cheese we don't eat.
Yeah.
Other than that, pretty much everything.
Yeah.
I mean, who eats blue cheese? It's like rotten cheese.
That's been like...
It stinks like...
Yeah.
I'm actually allergic to mold, so no moldy cheese for me.
Mold?
I swear I'm allergic to mold. I have it on my paper.
Oh, someone asked, why is your sister verified and not you?
Oh.
I don't know. Ask Instagram.
Because I applied for my verification on Instagram like 10 times. And I applied once, and then 1 month later...
No, so you know what's funny?
I got verified.
I didn't believe it.
We didn't know that you can apply it on through your Instagram profile. And I applied it first, and I told Laura, hey, you can apply it through Instagram. She did, and she got verified, and I didn't.
But it took like a month.
It took more than a month.
I don't know why I didn't get verified.
It's not fair. I don't know, maybe because Laura has a website.
Yeah.
That she was like doing blog on it before.
So it's kind of like, and maybe like, so, I mean, I don't know.
We should get you verified.
Yeah.
Somehow. Top favorite shoes. Must-haves.
Well, number one is orange sandals from Hermes.
Oh yeah, that's for summer.
Well, that's one shoe that is a my must-have.
Oh, Pigalle from Christian Louboutin.
Yeah.
These are, some people think they're uncomfortable. They are at the beginning, but if you start wearing them a lot, then they become comfortable and they're very sexy. So it's a must, kind of.
Kind of a must.
They go with everything.
What else?
I really like my Jimmy Choo boots because I was wearing them last year all winter and like autumn, and they still don't even have one scratch on them. So they're such a good investment. Like, I'm gonna be wearing them all winter this year, and they're still gonna look good. So it's like my favorite shoe.
Maybe also Stuart Weitzman, the nudist sandals.
Because they're super sexy and match with everything as well.
Yeah, and they're not that expensive. Yeah.
And then probably my Aquazora heels. Those are my favorite at the moment.
Oh, and my favorites are the Valentino.
The Rockstar.
Oh, the Rockstar.
These are my favorite because they're
the most super
comfortable.
And they're sexy and they're stylish. And they just make an outfit, you know?
Some people are saying that they're out of fashion already, but I don't care.
I don't follow fashion trends.
I don't follow fashion trends, and I feel like they're a classic.
Yeah.
Just because they're, you know, like they were maybe popular a few years ago, but I'm still gonna wear it, and I'm gonna buy more colors. Okay?
You know who's not gonna wear these shoes? The people who are wearing the Balenciaga, not Balenciaga, sorry, Bottega Veneta shoes, like one of
the duck shoes or something.
Because they like to follow fashion, so they're obviously not gonna wear the Valentino studs, but for me, I will wear them.
You'll never see me in those shoes.
Same.
Never.
What's one thing you hate about being an influencer?
all the hate probably that you get.
Yeah.
And like the pressure. Like you have pressure to
the pressure to always look good, and like you comparing yourself to other people, you know, like, oh, did my picture get enough likes, did this, like, oh, we're not growing, oh, we don't get enough likes, you know. It's just kind of like it, you know, you go a bit.
No, but I think the hate is like sad, although we don't get that much hate these days. Not yet.
We get a bit on YouTube, but we don't really care.
Yeah.
Influencer or celebrity you did not enjoy meeting?
Oh, we've had that question before.
Did we?
Yeah.
And what did we say?
I don't know.
Oh. Well, I'm definitely not gonna expose the influencers, because I don't think is it an influencer we didn't like?
Not really.
Not really, no.
A celebrity?
Celebrity. I remember when I met Nicki Minaj and I was taking selfies with her, she took all my phone and she deleted all the pictures because she didn't like it. But then she ended up posting a picture with you on her page.
Because, so the pictures that she deleted, she didn't know that are in the deleted folder on your iPhone. So I obviously took them back. I, you know, photoshopped her and myself. So she looks good. I posted the picture and then she posted it on her page.
So she reposted it.
Yeah, but she didn't tag me, obviously.
Oh.
But that was like 5 years ago.
No, that was more than 5 years ago.
Oh, yeah, but I still like
maybe
it.
More 5 years ago, yeah.
We like everybody, pretty much. Okay, this is an interesting question. Have you ever been offered to be a sugar baby?
Yeah.
When?
What's sugar baby?
Like, you know, by a sugar daddy. Have you been offered?
Well, yeah, we always get all these email messages and emails.
I mean, we never got offered in, like,
real life.
In, face to face, but...
Of course, on Instagram.
Instagram and, like, maybe messages, like, emails...
Yeah.
Emails.
It's and a lot funny. Of these DMs, like, super funny sometimes.
Yeah.
They're like, oh, this much, and I'm like,
what the hell?
People have no shame.
This is good as well. Did someone ever call you ho or similar words behind your back? And if yes, how did you deal with it?
Oh yeah, many times.
Many times.
Everyone calls us hoes.
Like, I mean, look at us.
The thing is, the how we deal with it is we just don't, because... If I know I'm not a hoe,
yeah,
I don't care. One can tell you otherwise.
Yeah.
If you know what kind of person you are, and if you know you're not a hoe, or I don't know, somebody, then, you know, you shouldn't be even, like,
touched by it,
or angry.
So many people call us hoes.
So many, and it's funny, it's laughable for me, because if I know laughable. I'm not a hoe, then, you know, it's like, alright, you can call me whatever, I know what I'm doing, I know what I did, you know,
yeah,
I'm fine.
People like to judge by the looks, see,
by the look, but not what they actually like know, because they know shit. They don't know shit.
You and Claudia wanted to get pregnant at the same time before 30. So is that happening soon?
I don't think so.
I never thought that was always Laura's stupid
idea. I mean,
idea.
We have 2 years.
You don't...
This is not in my head that I need to be pregnant before I'm 30. I don't care. For me, I feel like I'm 22.
But you're 28.
I know I'm 28, but I don't want children now. Not for another 5 years. I'm sorry.
So you're gonna be 33 and you're gonna...
I don't care. I can even be 40.
Alright.
This is not my priority in life. I want to travel. I want to do everything in life. Like, this is...
Well, that's why you have only 2 years now.
Yeah, but I'm not gonna...
The clock is ticking.
But this is something that it's not gonna be pressuring me that, oh my gosh, I need to have a baby before I'm 30. Love without money or money without love?
I mean, love without money, because then you can make money together, I guess.
Definitely love without money, because we've been there before.
Yeah.
We are the type of people that we can't just be with somebody for money and there is no love.
I've never been with somebody just for money.
So. Never. Like, I can't even imagine. Like, I'd rather be poor and, you know, have no money than be with someone just for money. Like,
yeah.
So, but... Have you ever had the same crush?
Yeah,
we did.
Because we like the same type,
kind of.
Yeah.
Have you ever been cheated on?
Yeah. Oh no, I haven't.
Why am I saying yes?
I have. I haven't.
Do you like your sister's ex?
No.
No one likes my ex. No one likes
good
my
luck.
Ex.
Good
nobody
luck.
Likes any exes. Like,
good luck to the person who's my ex. haven't told each other. I don't have any secrets.
Yeah. I'm sure you do.
Probably, but I'm not gonna say it on camera.
Claudia never tells me anything, because she's a sly, like she's a snake.
No, I'm not a snake, there's some stuff you just keep a secret. But nothing important anyway. If you both like the same guy, how does it end?
It doesn't, well, it doesn't have a beginning and it doesn't have an end.
Yeah. Unless I get him.
I'm kidding.
No, yeah. This is a funny one. Did you ever had a pregnancy scare? Yeah, I just had it now. I didn't have my period for like 2 months, and I thought, oh my goodness.
Did you check the test? No.
No.
Oh.
But I think I got my period today, so yeah.
Okay.
There you go. Do you think that Claudia is prettier than you?
No.
We're the same.
We're obviously a bit.
We're not the same, but we have differences.
We have our own, you know.
Okay, Claudia may have better hair than me at the moment. Because obviously I bleached mine, so mine's like all thin and like breaking, and she's got thicker hair.
Yeah.
So, you know, maybe she's got better hair, but like
I have
other things that are better.
Yeah.
Yeah. She's got better teeth, you know, some other bits.
Yeah.
So.
Paid a lot of
I have teeth. Better boobs. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, we're the same. So everyone is asking, how do you stay thin?
Oh, I was gonna say something else.
You have the same question there, how do you stay slim?
Oh yeah.
So the question is, you don't. The woman's body changed literally in a week. So we basically are naturally very skinny, but if we eat a lot, we're gonna gain weight.
Yeah,
there's no question.
And the thing is, when we were 20, we wouldn't gain weight.
No.
But after 25, this is when we started gaining weight. So
now we've been eating super bad for the past like 2 months and we gained 3 kilos each.
Yeah, 3 kilos.
No workout, no healthy eating. You gain weight. And if we're gonna continue, then we gain more weight. Yeah. But that's why now we kind of have to stop. Because yeah. We know that if we gain already 3 kilos, then this is the breaking point. We need to start
because
exercising.
It looks
like it shows on us. Yeah. 3 kilos to some people might be nothing, but to us it like shows
a lot.
We see it. We see it in the arms, we see it in the stomach.
Yeah.
So yeah. But our body's changing every day. Yeah. Like in the morning you wake up with a 6-pack, in the evening you look 6 months pregnant. And anyway, if you want to eat a lot like us, you have to exercise a lot.
Yeah, obviously.
This is our thing. Like, we have to exercise every single day.
Although we haven't.
If we want to, like, you know, keep the body.
True.
So, yeah. Keeping a good body is a lot of work.
It's difficult.
Yeah. Should I get a cat?
Yes.
You should.
They're the best thing in the world.
Right. A lot of people are asking if we have lip filler and if we would consider doing it. No, we don't, but I think we will, probably.
What?
We always said that we would never ever do a lip filler, but
Until we realized
that actually your lips get smaller.
And we can see
with
that already.
With age, and we can see that already.
We are 28, and our lips used to be quite much bigger than this.
A lot bigger.
And now they look like...
We've been overlining them a lot these days because they don't look as full as they used to look. They used to look so plump and stuff.
Yeah.
I feel like by the time we're like 35, we're probably gonna have fillers. But we would probably do a 0.5 mil, like not 1 mil, because 1 mil is too much. Because we obviously already have big lips. Not big, but like okay lips.
Yeah.
We wouldn't like full lips.
Yeah.
We have full lips, but yeah, probably by the time we're 35, the lips are gonna be like shrunk.
Though they're already shrinking really fast because you lose collagen and production, whatever.
Yeah.
I was Googling it. And this is why when you see like older people, they have like all these like wrinkles and
like our mom has no lips.
Our mom has no lips, and I asked her, did you have bigger lips like when you were younger? She's like, yeah. And we looked at her photos, she actually had lips like us.
Really?
And now she's like this.
Literally. So never say never, and I'm pretty sure we're gonna do it.
Probably like very minimal, but we probably will.
Yeah.
Anyway, I think we're gonna finish with these questions because this got me a bit tipsy.
Same, I'm like, my eyes are all over the place.
And we need to make dinner later, so yeah.
We're gonna make dinner. What are we gonna do now?
I think I'm just gonna maybe edit some pictures.
When was the last time you posted? I think it was like 5 days ago.
Yeah.
as bad.
No.
Quite busy. No. Busy doing more like lazy. Oh well. Anyway, I think we're gonna catch with you later.
Yeah. We're about to cook up some dinner.
Yes, we're gonna make some chicken with some stuffed mozzarella and sun-dried tomatoes.
And basil.
And basil. Super easy, takes like half an hour.
Yeah.
And then we're gonna have some mashed potato as well, like a creamy mashed potato.
Yeah,
you know?
I haven't had mashed in a while.
I had it yesterday, but I want it again.
Oh. Okay, so we put the camera here so you can kind of see what we're doing.
Yes, I'm just gonna do potatoes, so that's easy.
Claudia decided to be doing the, like, peeling the potatoes.
Because it's an easy job, alright?
I have the difficult job, so I'm gonna do the chicken.
You wanted to do that.
Not my fault.
Okay, everything is kind of prepared. What should I do first? Should I like marinate
the Yeah, meat? Just marinate the chicken first.
So we like to put this garlic and chili paste first on the chicken. Kind of like rub it in it, basically.
Yeah, just give him a little rub.
Give him a little rub. We get these in like Sainsbury's.
Yeah.
Garlic and chili paste always gives a nice flavor. You just kind of rub it like that.
I washed my hands, by the way. And even if I didn't, then it's fine.
I didn't, actually.
Ew.
But I'm gonna wash the potatoes, it's fine.
I like a garlicky chili.
Oh my god.
What?
Luther, come!
He wants food.
That ain't for you, my dear. So basically, I saw this recipe on Instagram and I tried it and it was so good. You stuff mozzarella, sun-dried tomatoes and some basil inside the chicken and then you stick it in the oven for like half an hour.
Yeah.
It is really good.
Tastes so good and like something different, you know?
Yeah.
And it's kind of healthy, I would say.
We have a big ass mozzarella. We're gonna cut it into like slices.
And if you want to be more healthy, you can use the like light mozzarella, but
yeah,
I don't want to do that. I wanna have the full fat cheese.
Yeah, I feel like this one tastes better.
True.
So you just kind of cut it into slices. I'm gonna add some other flavors, like some salt, some roasted garlic, herb type of thingy. It's really nice.
Oh my gosh, I wish we had like cheese to put on top of the mashed potato. You know how they do it sometimes?
Oh yeah. And I'm gonna put some oregano as well. This gives a nice flavor.
To be honest, we have cheese. We could do that. I kind of bake it for like 10 minutes in the oven.
Oregano, pepper. So I added all the flavors on the other side as well. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut into these pieces kind of from like kind of like that, and make like a hole.
You sure?
I guess so. I mean, I used to do it here and then I would stuff it like this, but I think you're supposed to cut it from the from that angle.
Mm.
Kind of like this.
Oh my gosh, Venus, what are you doing? She's going into the bin.
What?
Yeah, look.
Right, so you make an incision kind of like that.
Shall I help you?
I've never done this type of incision. Oh my gosh, that looks so funny.
Ew!
Okay, and then you're basically gonna stuff all the goods inside this little hole. Well, it's not that little. Well, that looks pretty good. Look, you have a nice little hole. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna put all the goods.
Maybe this first.
Mozzarella. The sun-dried tomatoes.
Yeah. These are big.
Yeah.
I like what I see.
I'm gonna, yeah, that's enough. And then you add some basil, like that. Just stuff it up there, like so. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna use some toothpicks and we're gonna close it so it doesn't break. I can add a bit more.
It's breaking here.
Don't worry. Take the toothpicks and then we're gonna close it.
Basically, you do this. You have to put quite a few. So
yeah, you have to put a lot.
Yeah.
And there you have
Pluto.
Pluto, stop crying. Yeah, that's fine.
These cats are funny.
It is enough.
But
But there is still like a hole here.
It doesn't matter.
So this is what your chicken looks like now. Nice and stuffed. If you have like a hole, you can just like secure it from different angles. Like so. There you go, that's ready. Put it here.
Nice.
I'm gonna make this one now.
Do you have to spray it with like some olive oil or no?
Oh yeah, actually I forgot about that. To be honest, I'm not looking at the recipe because I don't know where the recipe is. You know, I saw it on Instagram.
I think I'm just gonna put the potatoes to boil. Well, first I'm gonna wash them and then start boiling them.
Alright, so that looks better.
Some olive oil.
There you go, nice little hole. Yeah, that's a good one. Go, second one. I don't know how we're gonna cut this because this is really small. This one was a bit difficult. Make sure you get a nice kind of
nice
breast
piece like those two.
Yeah,
this one was a bit like wonky
and small as well. With small ones it's quite difficult to do.
Yeah. How about we cut this side and we stuff some mozzarella on the side? Kind of like that, yeah. Just cut it through. This is gonna be a double one.
Like that?
Yeah. Double mozzarella.
Basically what you do, once this is cooked, you remove the toothpicks. There you go. There is your little stuffed chicken.
I think we're gonna cook this for what, half an hour or
25 minutes to
maybe
half an hour
because these big pieces.
Yeah, because these are big, so if it's big you kind of cook it for half an hour. So yeah, this is what it looks like so far.
Half an hour on maybe 180 or something.
180 200.
Yes.
I'm gonna check. I'm not sure, to be honest.
Yeah.
Oh, and some olive oil, I forgot,
but not too much,
literally just a splash. A bit of olive oil.
Right.
That's good. Good to go to the oven. Okay, the potatoes are ready to
be mashed.
So the trick is you can't cook them for too long.
You can't overcook them, basically.
Yeah, you can't overcook them because if you overcook them, they're gonna be like watery. So your mash, it won't be like nice. It's gonna be watery inside. So we're just gonna mash that up. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna add some cream. This is the cream that we used for our soup.
Oh my god, so much cream today.
So most people add like milk, but I'm gonna add cream to make it extra creamy.
Yeah,
this
extra
is one
fatty.
Extra fatty. And of course we're gonna add butter as well to this lovely mixture.
Loads of butter, loads of cream, loads of calories.
And basically, you have to mash this for really long till it becomes so creamy.
Really?
Yeah.
Why sometimes it looks very yellow and sometimes white?
It just depends on the potatoes, you know, the quality of the potatoes. So you have to like go in with it. Let me add some butter.
Oh my gosh, we literally nearly finished the whole butter today.
True.
This is how we keep fit. This is how we keep skinny.
This is the trick. Some butter, some more cream.
Look at here on the floor. Somebody came to play.
What do you want, little girl? You want food?
She wants food. She can see it in the oven that something's cooking.
Yeah.
Ow!
So yeah, the trick is to literally mash this for so long.
And obviously it needs to be salty.
This is not very good. You need a metal one. This plastic is not very...
Sorry, boss.
How is the chicken? Oh my gosh, the cheese is kind of melting out. I don't know if you can see it.
It's looking rather
juicy. It looks juicy.
Right, back to the mash.
Should we make some salad or something?
Yeah, I think I'm gonna make like a side salad with some maybe cherry tomatoes and cucumber. I don't know. Something easy.
Something fresh. Right, I'm gonna be doing this for a while.
Alright.
I'm making kind of like a Shirazi salad. It's like a Persian salad. Quick and easy, some red onion, cucumber, so, tomato.
This is what the mash looks like. Extra creamy.
Oh my gosh, Laura, Venus is on your bag.
Venus! No! These sun-dried tomatoes are getting burned.
Yeah, because they were not hidden enough. Because I feel like you need to like hide them properly. Okay, Claudia decided to go and get some gravy for the mash because we don't want it to be dry, and I'm gonna finish the salad. That was quick.
Yeah.
Finish the salad. Looking nice.
Got some gravy.
Yeah. Okay, so the chicken's ready. We're gonna take these things out. What do you call them? Toothpicks.
Oh my god.
That's a lot of cheese.
So much cheese.
There you go. Ooh, yeah. Make a nice bowl. Salad, and the dinner is served. Look at it. I really love this chicken. The dinner is ready. Look at it. Can't wait to eat it. Oh, and obviously some gravy on top.
Oh yeah, we're gonna put the gravy as well.
Yeah.
But I don't know if we should put it now.
Maybe later.
So this is what it looks like, the close-up. Mmm, yummy.
Right, we're gonna eat the dinner. I'm probably gonna go home after.
Yeah, because it's kind of late already. It's already 10 o'clock, I think.
What?
Yeah.
I don't like eating this late.
It's fine. Anyway, I guess we're gonna see you in the next video.
Bye.
I think gravy was a good idea.
It needs to be a lot of gravy because, you know, I don't like dry food.
Let's try. Same, we like sauce. Try my mash.
Mmm.
Good? I think good with gravy, right?
I'm gonna try the chicken.
Because looks dark. A bit burned, but it's pretty nice. I'm sure it's gonna be nice.
Mmm.
Yeah?